Hello and welcome to our FPL show. It's game week 4 coming up and I'm joined again by Brendan Neto, our FPL coach, to take a look at some tips and tricks ahead of the upcoming game week. Let's start then with the league leader heading into game week 4.
Yeah, team name Avengers 11, and he certainly gained some ground. Well, actually, he's actually lost a bit of ground, I beg your pardon. But he's still number one, only 40 points this week, but that kind of just tells you the kind of week it's been. You know, the players that you thought would perform didn't really do well, and a lot of, you know, differentials came through. So he's only got 40 points this week. Went with Aguero for captain. You know, Wolves away, a little bit difficult. He was a bit unfortunate, you have to say. He did hit the woodwork twice in that game. I think he's still got a very good team. I wouldn't change too much. I look at maybe, you know, Firmino, even though he picked up an assist, I do think he's dropping off a little bit behind Salah and Mane, and they are kind of playing like out and out strikers, aren't they? So a little bit of his threat is being taken away. He may want to, you know, downgrade him and free up some money. You know, there are great options now for mid-price strikers, Mitrovic, Wilson coming through. So options there for him. I think he's got Alonso in his defense, but he doesn't have Mendy or Robertson. So I think he'd want to add one of them at least. I think Trippier is showing some really good form now as well. So some options for him there. And Eriksen in midfield, I think, is something else that he could consider. Just because I feel like Eriksen's playing a little bit deeper this time, and with Trippier taking over a lot of the set pieces, that's kind of removed a little bit of his threat as well. And like most people, he's got Richarlison in his team. -2 there with a, you know, straight red card. So he'll be thinking about, you know, moving him on as well.
We're seeing quite a lot of movement, obviously, as it's the opening weeks and the scores have been quite similar, other than perhaps game week 2, where we saw some really high scores. What's interesting, though, is quite a lot of teams have got two home games coming up, haven't they, with after the international break. So is it important to have an eye on game week 5 as well?
Yeah, definitely. You never know what's going to happen, you know, during the international break. And that's where your first wild card of the season can come in handy. It can also be used later on when there's possibly a first double game week towards the end of December. So, you know, there are options there, but if there are a lot of injuries during the international break, even now, if you had, you know, two of the players who were sent off, for example, you'd be thinking about changing things around a bit.
Okay, then you've mentioned Richarlison, which is definitely one to think about after his red card. Any other team news that people should be aware of? Any people that have been selected by a lot of gamers and maybe need to come out?
Yeah, I think the main one is Arnautovic. He picked up a knock last time around, so he does. It looks as if he'll still play. There's a 75% chance, and you know, I'd still back him for that. He's at home to Wolves. So, yeah, I wouldn't panic just yet and get rid. I think he's shown some great form. He looks like the kind of striker who can score against anyone. Doesn't matter who he's playing. He showed that against Arsenal as well. So, yeah, I would keep him. But I guess the big thing is Richarlison replacements. Because his price is rapidly falling as well. As it should, because they've got two really comfortable home fixtures up next, and he's missing both of them. I think he's back against Arsenal, if I'm not mistaken, and then from then on the fixtures aren't quite as appealing. So yeah, the people will have to consider replacing him.
Well, of course, Arnautovic last season was a midfielder. He's now a striker. But there's quite a few midfielders out there, aren't there, who are picking up points, picking up goals from those attacking positions. Of course, we saw Lucas Moura on Monday night as a prime example of that. There are a couple as well with Walcott and Pereira even, who are really playing those advanced roles and picking up goals and points.
Yeah, you could even throw, you know, Pedro in there as well. And those are kind of the players you would think about when it comes to replacing Richarlison. I thought with Pereira, he's showing some really good form. But the problem with him is fixtures. There's a big turn in fixtures right now for Watford. It gets really difficult. I think they play play four of the top six in the next five or six games. So it's a tough run for them. And that's the only reason why I would maybe avoid him. To bring in, I'd say Walcott is the safest bet. just because under Marco Silva, Everton looked like they're always going to score goals. And with, you know, the next couple of fixtures, especially, I think Walcott may even, you know, play even more advanced. He's kind of started deeper and then he's broke forward quickly, whereas Richarlison has kind of, you know, started in a little bit of more advanced role, and he's kind of tucking in and, you know, almost alongside the striker. But with him out, I think Walcott, you know, there'd be more onus on him to perform. So.
Okay, so he's certainly one that you should look to bring in. But who are you looking to captain in game week 4?
Well, it's hard to look past Sergio Aguero, really. I think he's in sensational form. I wouldn't have captained him against Wolves last week. I went with Salah instead. But he did still show that he's very sharp. And when a striker of his caliber is in the form he is at the moment, he's fit, he's firing, you kind of have to back him, you know, while the going is good. And yeah, that's the thinking behind Aguero. Newcastle will be visiting the Etihad as well, and Aguero does enjoy playing against them. You know, he scored 10 goals in his last 5 appearances against them, 8 in just his last 2. So I think, you know, Rafa is obviously going to come to the Etihad and try to park the bus. He was, you know, very solid and disciplined at home to Chelsea, but I think City have just so much more than Chelsea in terms of their ability to break down teams that just want to sit on the edge of their own box and defend. A big part of that, obviously, is you know, their wingbacks, Mendy and Walker, and Mendy in particular. I'm guessing Guardiola will go with the 3-5-2 again. Jesus and Aguero both to start, maybe, and yeah, I think there's going to be a lot of chances there for him.
There we go then, there you have it. Aguero, captain again. He loves playing against Newcastle and he may well enjoy himself again this weekend. Brendan, thank you very much as ever for your insightful analysis. We hope you have a great game week and enjoy the rest before we start back up with game week 5. Thanks very much.